dear. Welcome to my modest home. And what can I do for you? Oh, yes. I forgot. I invited you here to answer in one fell swoop all the questions you've been bugging me about popular music. And of course, you came to the right place because they don't call me Pops von Drake for nothing. They gotta pay me. Come in and sit down, and I'm going to play for you several hundred of the latest hit songs of the past 60 years, which naturally I wrote myself. Around the turn of the century, I was a starving musician, and I was down to my last rutabaga. And anybody knows what that means. I was dressed in rags all the time. Even my clothes was in rags. And I said to myself, that's it. I will call my new syncopation ragtime. Now, naturally, there were many cheap imitations of my ragtime. There was Ludwig's ragtime band. And then there was ragtime cowboy Ludwig. And then there was the dishpan rag. And many others which shall be nameless because I can't remember what they are. But now I'm going to give you a demonstration of my now famous rutabaga rag.
Rutabaga, ragging to the rutabaga, 'cause they know it's harder than a hot potato, harder than a hot potato. It's got a new beat. It's called a two beat. Radishes and onions are getting corns and bunions, ragging to the rutabaga, rag. Brussels sprouts are wearing out their new galoshes, dancing with the summer squashes. Let us do it. And asparagus and limers, they're becoming real ragtimers. By the numbers, broccoli and celery and cool cucumbers. Love that little syncopator, lifts you like an elevator. Red hot rutabaga rag. That little syncopator lifts you like an elevator. Red hot rutabaga, red hot rutabaga, red hot rutabaga rag. Red hot!
Popularity is fickle, and soon my ragtime was worn to shreds, and the people shouted, Ludwig, pay your bills! No, that isn't what they said. That was my laundryman who said that. But I'm trying to remember. Now, let's see what they said. Oh, yes. They said, Ludwig, give us a new sound in popular music. So I gave them a new sound. It was the roaring 20s, the days of raccoon coats and the sheiks and the flappers and the tin lizzies. The wireless was replacing the gramophone. You know something? I don't know why they called it a wireless, because look at all those wires there. Some nut called it a wireless. Maybe that's why they changed the name to radio, which is really O-E-D-A spelled backwards. I happened at the time to be below the Mason-Dixon line, you see, and Mr. Dixon came up to me and he said, Mr. von Drake, sir, you all had just better put old Dixie on the map. I said to myself, little old Ludwig, sir, I said, it's up to you all. So I wrote Louisville Ludwig, a song about me, naturally. But to protect the innocent, me, I changed the name to Charleston Charlie.
Who's our campus a dreamboat? Charleston Charlie, oh, Charleston Charlie's our boy. Oh, gee, oh, joy, he's got it and then some. Ooh, he's so handsome, oh, Charleston Charlie's our guy. Oh, me, oh, my, he's slick, he's smooth, he's got savoir faire. He's romancy, talks so fancy, the answer to a flapper's prayer. All the girls go gaga, ooh, when you roll your Valentino eyes. Ooh, Charleston Charlie, oh Charleston Charlie, it's a poo-poo-pee-doo, a poo-poo-pee-doo, you. gargle. When you roll your Valentino your eyes, ooh, Charleston Charlie, oh Charleston Charlie, it's a poo 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 doo, a poo 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 doo, a you. A poo 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 doo, a poo 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 doo, a you.
Charleston, Charleston, Charleston. Oh boy, am I poopopadooped. Things really began to get rough. We had a depression. Wall Street laid an egg. It was more like an omelet. And the roaring 20s went out with a peep. But was Von Drake depressed? You can bet your boots I was, because all my money was lost in debt and I couldn't stand for it. What am I saying? I wasn't depressed, not on your life, because I knew that the world was waiting for me, Ludwig von Drake, to pull the world out of depression. And I pulled them out of depression into complete poverty, single-handed. And so there I was, down to my last nickel. I ate it. No, what am I saying? I went into a 5 and 10 cent store feeling like $1 million, and I bought myself a piano. And it was on this noble instrument that I modestly wrote my greatest forever remembered hit. Soon every band in the nation picked it up and threw it out. Wait a second, what am I saying? They didn't throw it out. They started to play it. Everybody was playing it.
Although I dropped 100,000 in the market, baby, I found $1 million in your smile. Yes, sir, stocks are crashing every day. Banks are failing too. But who cares if those skies are gray? Long as I have you, dear. Once I was a millionaire on margin. Now I'm singing in the breadline. All the while, although I dropped 100,000 in the market, baby, I found $1 million in your smile. Yes, sir, there I was, sitting on top of my lonely flagpole, thinking of the money I lost. The factory was closed, and who knew when we'd start manufacturing running boards again? How could I let a smile be my umbrella when it was stormy weather all the time? Although potatoes were cheaper, now was definitely not the time to fall in love. And then I spied you selling apples on the corner. Delicious! And you looked up at me and smiled. And the sun came shining through. And I slipped down from my pole because I knew it was pointless. Although I dropped 100,000 in the market, baby, I found $1 million in your smile. I'm happy I found $1 million in your smile. You betcha I found $1 million in your smile. Yes.